as I said before, this passage of scripture that I read to you, which, by the way, was the New Revised Standard Version of that text, fixes something that happened a long time ago. I was going to ask you to raise your hand if you remember the story of Adam and Eve in the garden with the temptation. Then I thought that's a pretty silly thing to ask you to do. But you remember the story? Adam and Eve were having a pretty good time in the garden, living there, until one day temptation comes their way, and Eve is tempted by that hissing snake in the garden that said, "Hey, Eve, how are you? You know what? Did God tell you that you shouldn't eat the fruit of that tree?" She says, "Yeah." He says, "Don't listen to him. Don't listen to him. He just doesn't want you to be like him. If you eat that fruit, you'll have the ability to be like God." And then you know what happened. There was that little error where she takes a bite of the fruit and then she serves dinner to her husband as well. And before you know it, they are expelled from the garden. And if you think about what that sin was it that they simply disobeyed God because God said, "Don't eat the fruit," so they ate it? They ate it? Not really. Listen to what the temptation was. If you eat that fruit, you will become like God. You'll be able to know the difference between good and evil. Not only will you know the difference, but like God, you'll have the ability to judge good and evil, something that really only belongs to God. And we know that. And so that was really that first sin, that humankind wanted to be like God, and judgment came into the world. Human judgment. One of the first things that happens is Adam and Eve look at each other and they realize they're different for the first time. Why was that? Because now they were looking at other people, at each other in this case, and they're noticing, they're making judgments about each other. Very, very interesting. And how much a part of our life that can be. How difficult it is for us to not fall into the temptation to wanting to be like God and be in the judgment of other people's business. Sometimes we do it, I suspect, to feel better about ourselves. You know, like the Pharisee in the scripture who says, "Oh, thank God I'm not like that person over there." Pretty great. Or sometimes we do it just to make sure that we're doing better, maybe, than our friends or our family or someone else. But sin is sin. And whenever we are ready to judge other people, trying, like us, to take on God's responsibility, that's when sin enters into our life. So what's the fix for all of this? Well, Paul talks about it in his letter to the church of Philippi. Let me read that again, only this time from the translation called The Message. This is what he said. "Think of yourselves the way Christ Jesus thought of himself. He had equal status with God. He had gotten the same. But didn't think so much of himself that he had to cling to the advantages of that status no matter what." No, not at all. "When the time came, he set aside the privilege of his deity and took on the status of a slave. He became human. And having become human, he stayed human. It was an incredibly humbling process. He didn't claim special privileges. Instead, he lived a selfless, obedient life. And then he died a selfless, obedient death. And the worst kind of death at that, crucifixion. Because of that obedience," which is the opposite of the disobedience in Genesis, "God lifted him high and honored him far above anyone or anything ever, so that all created beings in earth and in heaven, even those long ago dead and buried, will bow and worship before this Jesus Christ and call out in praise that he is master of all to the glorious honor of God the Father, who, although he was in the form of God, emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human form, He became obedient, even to the point of death. The celebration that we look forward to now, just 2 weeks away, the celebration of Easter, is made possible by God's gift to us in Christ Jesus, who by example taught us not to be judgmental of one another, but to turn to God for forgiveness and grace, and to love each other as Christ has loved us. That's the challenge in these 40 days. That's the challenge of our whole life. Let's pray a prayer.